Hey guys, I'm Lee Tyler. That's the 2021 Skoda Octavia, and this is a Right Lane Review.
Modern automotive landscape, SUVs reign supreme, but a few brands have managed to keep the sedan and wagon segments alive. One of those brands is Skoda, and their ever-present Octavia.
Skoda has been making user-friendly daily drivers for decades, and for a long time, the Octavia has been the prime mover. But in the sedan realm, the Toyota Camry and the Mazda 6 reign supreme. So with this new redesign, what can Skoda offer? So what is the Octavia bringing? Well, to start with, it's a refresh on an already existing platform, but some brand new technology, which means this car is now ready for a modern era. This particular car we're in this week is the Ambition model, which is kind of the base model for the Octavia. It has some pretty decent standard features, adaptive cruise control, for example. It does have some of the new safety tech out front, a new drivetrain, as well as a full digital dash and a bigger infotainment display. So the car does have the typical Skodaism, so it has the eye scraper in the fuel flap, and it has a umbrella in the door. But you also have a couple other things, like you can option in an iPad holder for the back seat. This one has a trash can in the door bin, which is a nice little touch. And it has a cool glove compartment, as well as some really elaborate and really inventive ways of storing cargo in the back. And that just gives you the kind of detail that you don't necessarily get in some of the other brands out there. I think that's what really makes Skoda different, is that bit of quirk. Overall, it's a typical Octavia, so it's easy to drive. It's very smooth around town. This is what I like to call taxi spec. So this isn't anything super frilly, but it has all the necessary items. And if you're after kind of back to basics, driving in a vehicle that's going to be really utilitarian, this is the one to go for. This would be equivalent to like a Camry, a lower base Camry, or a base model Mazda 6. So it's pretty usual car. I think it actually feels a bit more upmarket than the Camry personally, and on par with the Mazda 6, because the Mazda 6 does have a beautiful interior. But when you get out on the open road, you really start feeling the difference in the car. So this has a brand new drivetrain for this platform, which is Volkswagen Group's 1.4-liter turbocharged petrol engine, a 8-speed traditional automatic instead of the old dual clutch, so it's a lot smoother around town. And the pairing makes about 250 newton meters of torque and 110 kilowatts. Dynamically, it is a base model Octavia, so it's not going to win any drag races with a little engine pairing, though it is reasonably brisk. You throw it into a corner, it's not going to do anything out of the ordinary. It feels very competent and easy. The one thing I will say about it is that it feels like it's been set up to carry people and gear and heavier than most sedans. So it's got kind of an odd kind of sit in the suspension, so the back end sits a little bit higher on the front end. And I reckon that's just from it being designed to carry stuff and carry heavy stuff and multiple people and go on long trips, which is what you would want to do in a car like this. And that rear suspension can tend to kind of clunk over bumps, or if you hit a speed bump or a pothole the wrong way, it kind of tends to bang a little bit, which is a bit odd, but that's probably just the way this particular one's specced up. Now, we do have a RS and a VRS version of the Octavia hopefully coming to Australia, and the VRS comes along, it will give us GTI power in this Octavia shape, and I reckon that could potentially be the one to have, because this Octavia's quite good. How's the interior on the new Octavia? Well, it's using Volkswagen's new design philosophy, so it looks fantastic and looks more premium than some of its competitors, even though it is still at the entry-level price point. You sit behind a nice new wheel, which feels pretty good in the hands, and has kind of these flying buttress effect buttons on either side with the chrome knobs. I actually quite like them personally. A couple paddle shifters, the beautiful digital driver's display directly in front of you, which is another Volkswagen specialty, and it looks fantastic. Have a nice big infotainment screen in the middle, even though it is skewed away from the driver. It's using a couple of haptic touch tricks, and they're not all that intuitive, so they have to be a bit touchy, but you can get over it. It does have Apple CarPlay and Android Auto wirelessly, as well as wireless charging here in the bottom, and the new nubbin thing that the Volkswagen, Audi, Skoda is using for their transmissions. Throughout, plenty of cubbies and spaces to put different bits and bobs in typical Skoda fashion, some clever bits, cooled glove compartment. So overall, it's a pretty nice place to be. So how's the back seat in the Octavia? Well, it is very typical Octavia, so I have plenty of knee and leg room, plenty of head and shoulder room as well. And in this Ambition model, there's not a ton of extras out back, just a couple of vents for the aircon out front. Beyond that, a couple of bins, nice big pockets for a tablet, and a smaller pocket for maybe your small phone or something. And you also have a armrest and a couple of easy access cup holders. So pretty simple, but it does the job. So how's the boot in the back of the Octavia? Well, to start with, this lovely coupe-like body hides a massive rear hatch. And once it's open, there is a ton of space back here. You could easily get a dog crate back here, maybe a couple of big bags, and trips to IKEA and Bunnings would be no issue because the seats also fold down flat. Plus you have cubbies around and some hooks for different bits and bobs, so plenty of usability. And the load floor mat is double-sided, so you have carpet on one side and plastic or like rubber on the other, so you keep things nice and clean. And underneath is a full-size spare. So this is easily my favorite feature. So what's the tops, bottoms, and final verdict on the 2021 Skoda Octavia? Well, on the bottom are a few things to keep in mind. One's the fact that despite this is a beautifully updated car, the interior lacks a couple of key pieces of tech, like blind spot monitors and keyless entry. The rear suspension is a little bit loud and jittery at times, which feels kind of odd. It doesn't drive quite as nice as something like a Camry or a Sonata, so make sure you give them all a test drive. So what's on top for the Octavia? Well, to begin with, it's a typical Skoda, so it drives well and feels pretty good in the hands, typical Volkswagen product. Not to mention, it's quite comfortable and has plenty of space on the inside. And the tech is pretty good too. I think it's a looker. On top of that, my favorite thing is the massive boot, which I've managed to stuff into a nice coupe-like body. So what's my final verdict for the 2021 Skoda Octavia? Well, this Ambition model is a fantastic entry for the Octavia lineup, and I think it gives you something a little bit different to think about in comparison against the Camry and the Mazda 6. So if you want something with quirk but all the usability, check out the Octavia. You have a digital driver's display. That's a digital driver's display, which is really nice.